are lying to inform external and internal surfaces by tissue layers consisting osteoprogenitor cells. From the external surface is the periosteum, connective tissue layer of collagen fibers and fibroblasts. And from the internal surface, we have a single layer of osteoprogenitor cells called endosteum. Endosteum is located around the marrow cavity, while periosteum on the external surface. This slide is section in the Grausen bone. We have spherical structure or rounded structure. This complex is composed of central canal called Habertian canal, surrounded by concentric lamina. So this structure is called Habertian system or osteum. Habertian canal surrounded by concentric lamina. The lamina located immediately beneath the periosteum are called outer circumferential lamina. And near the endosteum called inner circumferential lamina. Between these two systems of lamellae, we have irregular or triangular in shape lamellae. These are called interstitial or intermediate lamellae. This is Volkmann canal, connect between Habertian two Habertian canals. Transverse or oblique, connects between two Habertian canals. Habertian canals surrounded by lamellae, but Volkmann do not have concentric lamellae. The collagen fibers arrange in lamellae parallel to each other or concentrically around the Habertian system. These black dots are the osteocytes. These cells are situated between lamellae. Osteocytes are flattened or almond shaped. And their cytoplasmic processes found within the canaliculi. Because the matrix of the bone calcified, the metabolites are difficult to diffuse through it, so the matrix have spaces, appear as a thin cylindrical spaces. These spaces are called canaliculi. هذه مثل الخطوط المتعرجة هذه الكناليكولاي هي thin cylindrical spaces perforate the bone matrix house the cytoplasmic process of the osteocytes
silver.
This slide is stained with silver stain. المطلوب بهذا السلايد تعرفون around this structure هو ال Haversian system or osteoid. Central Haversian canal surrounded by lamellae. These are osteocytes. And we have canaliculi, the cylindrical spaces, and the outer and inner circumferential lamellae. These are intermediate or interstitial lamellae. Appear as irregular or triangular in shape. Second slide is a cross section through decalcified bone. Haversian canal, and this is Wolfman canal, connect between Haversian canals. And these black dots are the osteocytes. Only one osteocyte occupies single lacunae. This is bone marrow. فقط تعرفون انه هذا longitudinal section يشير للهافرشين كانون حتى تميزوا عن الكروس section. The stain of the last two slides are H1T. This is dissection in the membranous bone. Intramembranous ossification responsible as the source of the flat bones and taking place within a condensation of mesenchymal tissue. This is a primary bone tissue, appear as a spicule. At the surface, we have osteoblast. These cells are arranged side by side, resemble simple epithelium. When they are active, they are appear cuboidal or columnar in shape. In the center, we have calcified matrix. Within the matrix, we have osteocytes. These are osteocytes. At the surface, we have osteoblast. This layer is located between osteoblast cell layer and previously formed matrix. This layer is called osteoid. Osteoid is non-calcified matrix. Osteoid found between osteoblast layer and previously formed matrix. عادة تظهر لنا بشكل منطقة فاتحة. Third type of bone cells is the osteoclast. Osteoclasts are giant multinucleated cells found on surface depression called plough-shaped lacunae. The dilated portion of this cell consists of 5 to 50 nuclei. These cells are responsible for reabsorption and remodeling of bone tissue. Another osteoclast. From other slide, you show three types of cells. The on the surface, the tissue symbol epithelium here, osteoblast. The form within the matrix, osteocyte. The giant multinucleated cell is the osteoclast. Okay? This slide is stained with H1D stain. Last slide is a section in the bone developing. We will examine the epithelial plate. Endochondral ossification responsible for the growth of short and long bone. We have five zones. First zone is the resting zone. We can see chondrocytes without any morphological changes. So this zone is called resting zone. Second zone is the proliferative zone. Chondrocytes proliferate rapidly, forming columns of stacked cells. So this zone is proliferating zone. third zone is hypertrophic zone. We can see the chondrocytes are very large and the cytoplasm is full with the glycogen. Hypertrophic zone. Fourth zone is the calcification zone. The thin septum of the matrix become calcified with the death of chondrocytes. Last zone is the ossification zone. Bone, endochondral bone tissue is appear. With osteoprogenital cells form osteoblasts and other cells. This is ossification zone. عندكم اياها على السريع. First zone, the only chondrocyte without any morphological changes. Second zone is the proliferative zone, columns of stacked cells. Third zone is hypertrophic, large chondrocyte, and cytoplasm is formed with the glycogen. Fourth zone, death of chondrocyte and the thin septum of the matrix become calcified. Last zone is the ossification zone. The endochondral bone tissue is appear. This slide is stained with HND stain.